of course, once I call on him, we'll be watching a trailer of the movie that we're here to unveil. He happens to be a man of many parts as well. He attended film school in Hawaii and in Florida. He also attended law school at the very prestigious Abraham Lincoln University in California, and currently completing his PhD program at Walden University, Minnesota, in the United States of America. So ladies and gentlemen, before he comes up here to give us one or two things, I think it's time for us to watch the trailer of the movie. But please, I want us once again, with a rousing round of applause, let's appreciate and celebrate President, CEO, Hollywood Executive Studio. Put your hands together for the very charismatic director, Emma Ndebele Ogbuni. We celebrate you, sir. So I think we are ready for the trailer right about now. I'm happy we are having Nigerians that are breaking into Hollywood because sometimes I don't understand Nigerian movies. I was watching a Nigerian movie the other time. One guy died, his ghost started harassing people, and the ghost wanted to cross express. Okay, that can't jump the ghost. I never seen Okay that they jump ghosts before. But. So I'm happy we have people from Hollywood coming to help us iron things out.
Come on now.
That's so sad. It's my husband. Whatever you call him.
Hey. Are you up?
Well, I'm too sorry I couldn't make it to the
left. Give us
you know what I'm saying? What in God's name is going on? That's so sad.
I see you went to someone wrong.
Yes, for moral support.
You disrespected your
home. The team is still going through the normal processes of release. As at this point in time, we don't have the actual date yet. But my team and I has decided that the film will be premiered in the USA, in Los Angeles to be precise. So we need time to coordinate because we are getting some of our cast members and our crew members to be there during the premiere. So the process of getting the visa, we don't really know the timeline yet. And other things we'll need to put together. But I assure you that before the end of this year, we'll be able to watch the wedding news. Thank you.
Wow, thank you so very much. Okay. Director, just let us know like 2-3 months ahead. So people like us can enter my bus and start going to Los Angeles.
Yes.
Okay, next question.
Tell us your name, where you work for.
Good afternoon. Emma Ndebele Ogbuni from Thompson Studios. I'd like to know, the movie, will it be fitted for Nigerian cinema? That is, after the premiere in Los Angeles, will it be available in cinema in Nigeria?
Thank you so much, Punch. I really like Punch. I used to read Punch a lot when I was much younger.
You know what Punch me?
Actually, the movie is meant for Nigerian cinema, and we're also believing that it will be in Netflix before the end of the year. So it will be readily available to everybody in the end. Thank you.
I think the next question, Fatou, please bring the, okay, give her banga.
But there's somebody in the high team.
Thank you.
come, children of the world.
Thank you. This is a very, very brilliant question. Because in movie production, one of the things you consider is the audience. What age group, you know. But this very one has no age limit, because we did it in such a way that there are no offensive materials that were in there. So we did it in such a way that everybody, no matter the age group, can be able to watch it. And it has a lot to teach both the young and the old. Thank you so much.
All right, where's the Disney event?
Okay. I'll do the
Disney, right?
No, I'm not.
Huh?
Disney
again. I give the Disney now.
What she's mentioning at?
Give Guardian. Give Disney now.
Yes,
okay.
I want to know where the sentence of this movie was. The short film in Nigeria for the universe. And then secondly, I want to know the semantic preparation of this movie. What are we looking at for the subject matters? What are the messages of the movie?
Yeah, but let me answer this one first. Thank you so much.
The Guardian.
Okay. Yeah, the movie you saw, the trailer, is very beautiful. A lot of people have been asking whether it was shot here or in abroad. It was actually shot here. That is why I'm saying that the talent I see here is so marvelous. If things are well put in place with good budgeting, we can compete favorably with any other group anywhere in the world. And that is why I'm bent on building a bridge between Hollywood and Hollywood. So that wherever you are, you have your good stuff, you can be able to do it wherever you want to do it. Then the second part of your question is about
The theme.
It's actually a love, romance kind of genre. But I will not be able to go into the nitty-gritty of the book because it's not yet out. So that you'll be able to see the information. So did I answer your question? Thank you so much.
Okay, let me come to
TBC,
right?
Good afternoon, everybody.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah, my name is Robin. I work with TBC. I'd like to know, okay, we're talking about the location where it was shot, and I'd like to know the budget and how you intend to recoup the investment. We talk about premiering it outside the country. So I'd like to know the budget and the phases. I actually saw some phases there, but it's not too clear for my understanding. So I want to know those that join this game.
Most of the times, we don't tell people where the locations that we use in the movies. We can only tell people where the geographical location of where the movie was made. The movie was made here in Lagos. But we cannot just start pointing the movie was made in Celia Hotel or it was made in this and that. It doesn't happen that way. The budgeting, we are still on course. We have not finished because it's only when we're done that we can be able to tell the world this is the total budget of this movie. So we're not done yet. We are still working. The movie is still a work in progress. I think every business is usually profit focused, including movie production. So we also have a department that are working on that. So I cannot actually stay now here right now to say this is exactly our strategy, but I know that we are going to improve our.
Padu 101.
Okay, thanks.
STB, another question?
My name is Jane from CMC. I want to ask a question. When the movie is ripe and ready, are you going to create awareness for us to
Yes, thank you. We will be making announcements from time to time. There will be advertisements, promotions, and all that will be happening. So by the time we're done with everything, we'll announce the dates to be released in the cinemas possibly. And that will be happening here in Nigeria. Yes.
Thank you. Yeah.
Flip TV.
Yes,
okay, so I just want to answer one question real quick. Hello everybody, my name is Fortes, I'm with Silverberg TV. So
what's TV here?
Silverberg TV.
Silverberg.
So sorry, you said you've been in the industry for a long time. And in these years, I'd like to know some of the things you've done while you've been there. And primarily I want to know why you chose to produce a movie now. I mean, you've been in the years for a long time. What is it about coming into the Nigerian movie sector at this time that makes you want to put out a movie in Nigeria or a movie about Nigeria at this time?
Thank you so much. This is not the first time I'm working with a movie, but this is the first time I'm directing a movie by myself or producing using the word EP, which is executive producer. This is the first time. I've worked with a lot of projects in the US. I've worked in a lot of big, high budget productions. I've worked with this group, the Love Boat group. When they came back, they had this program, the Patriot. It's about a black lady that works in the White House of President Jefferson Davis. So it was a big project. We did it, and I worked in other big ones like Roman J. Israel Square by Washington, just to mention a few. Then the other side of the question, which is why am I choosing Nigeria to do the movie right now? Like I said in my opening remark, it has always been my wish to create a kind of a cross-linkage between Hollywood and Nollywood. And there's no way I can do that without knowing exactly what is happening here. So when I got the story, I decided that I have to do it here so that I'll be able to one-on-one work with the people here on ground and see exactly what that will look like. And I actually achieved my aim because I discovered that what I was thinking is not just a wild dream. It's something that can be achievable. So I saw that our people here, we have the skill, we have the talent. We can compete favorably with those of us that work in Hollywood. So that is the reason why I decided to do this here, and I actually achieved that here. So from what I have seen, I believe that I believe that people in Hollywood and people in Nollywood have favorably worked together. Yeah, without having that gap of these people are high, these people are low, it won't actually exist. So,
was anybody in Hollywood featured in this movie? I mean, you talk about reaching the gap, so did you bring anybody from Hollywood?
No, going forward, because I think that's a different question. Going forward, we are going to be bringing people from Hollywood and people from Nollywood to act together. We'll also collaborate equipment, because I discovered that some of the equipment we use in Hollywood, they are not here. And the reason for that is because of the budget. Some of the equipment we use there, the cost alone can actually fund a full movie here in Nollywood. So I think by bringing the two parties together, that's why I said it will be a win-win. The Hollywood will be able to benefit from our great skills, and we can also benefit from their investment in their high budget.
All right, thanks so very much. Please, let's appreciate the very hardworking director, Ima Onegu, once again. Please, a round of applause for him. You know,